Good morning, children. First of all, I wish you Happy New Year and wish you to be safe. Now, children, I am going to do the next chapter, that is lesson 13 time. In this, children, you all have a clock at home and you all know what is a wristwatch. A wristwatch is a watch which is worn on the hand. And here I'm going to show you this clock. All of you must be having a clock at home and you must know to see the time also. Now, children, I'm going to explain you here. I'll show you that you have 12 numbers in the clock. And how does it move? It moves from which side? It moves from left to right. If I stand like this, it will move from left to right. This is called clockwise. And when it moves from right to left, then it is called anti-clockwise. Now, children, you can see here 12 numbers are written. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So we will study about the 12-hour clock time. Now, in this, children, you have 5 minutes between this gap. From 12 to 1, you have 5 minutes. From 1 to 2, you have 5 minutes. From 2 to 3, you have 5 minutes. And so on, you have 5 minutes. Now, when this clock takes 2 rounds, that is, once it takes from 12 to 12, then again it takes, that is known as one day, which we call a day. Now see, one day is equal to 24 hours. In 24 hours, you have 1 hour, which is equal to 60 minutes. Now, 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. Now, children, again, I will show you the clock. I have written here also that a clock has 2 hands. Small hand tells hour, long hand tells minutes. Sure. Now, children, see. You have 2 hands here. This small one is telling you the hour. And this big one, the long one, is telling you the minutes. And this thin needle which is moving, this is seconds. Okay? Now, in this, children, I have explained you and I have drawn this clock also. Now, next you have year. Now, recently you have completed 1 year and now you have entered the new year, that is 2022. Now, in 1 year you have 365 days. You have 366 days in a leap year. And usually 1 year is equal to 365 1 upon 4 days. When you calculate that 1 upon 4 by 4, you get 1 more day. And that is added to the year when you have a leap year. And when do you have a leap year? When February has 29 days. Children, February, you have 12 months in a year. In that, February is the shortest month of the year, in which it has 28 days. But after every 4 years, February has 29 days. So as I told you, that one day is added here, and then February is, that year is called leap year, when you have February 29 days. Now, you have 1 year is equal to 365 days. This is average. 1 year is equal to 12 months. So how many months you have? 12 months. That is January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November and December. December is the last month and January is the first month of the year. Now in 1 month you have 30 days, but there are some months in which you have 31 days. That is January you have 31 days, then you have in March you have 31 days, May you have 31 days, July you have 31 days, so like this children. So, but when you have to calculate, then you will see that 1 month is equal to 30 days. Now, you have 1 month and in that 1 month you have how many weeks? You have 4 weeks. Now 1 week is equal to 7 days. 1 week is equal to 7 days. And children, 1 year has how many weeks? 52 weeks. So now this I have explained you because when you will do the sums, all this you should know and you should learn it by heart. Now here I am going to show you how to solve the sums. Now children, you all can practice at home and you can draw the clock also. Now here I'll give you one or two examples of how to convert into seconds or minutes. In the first sum, convert hour into minutes. Like suppose you have 7 hours and you have to convert into minutes. So you will write 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. So the next step will be you will multiply 7 into 60 is equal to 7 zeros are 0 and 7 sixes are 42. So your answer will be 420 minutes. Now next, if you have to write that one convert 1 month into weeks. So 1 month, here I will write 2 months. Okay. Now, you will write 1 month is equal to 4 weeks. Therefore, 2 months, I'm writing the short form of months, is equal to 2 into 4 is equal to 8 weeks. So children, this is how you have to solve the sums. I will send you the solution of the exercise. Like one more example I will give you. If you have to convert minute into seconds. So you have 25 minutes. Okay. Now you will write here 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. So next step will be you will multiply 25 into 60. You know this multiplication? 0, when you multiply 25, you will get 0 here. 6 fives are 30, carry 3, 6 twos are 12 and 3, 15. So, what is the answer? How many seconds you have in 25 minutes? You have 1500 seconds in 25 minutes. So children, same way, when you have to convert months into days or year into months, you are going to apply this formula, and first you will learn all this, which is given in the book also, and I will send you the PDF of the chapter. Now children, convert weeks into days. 3 weeks. So how many days are there in a week? There are 7 days in a week. So you will write here 1 week is equal to 7 days. Now next step will be that you will multiply 3 by 7. Therefore, 3 weeks is equal to 3 into 7 is equal to 21 days. This is how you have to do. Then next, you will convert years into months. Now you can take 4 years. Now how many days in a year? How many? 365 days. How many months in a year? You have 12 months. So you are going to write here first, 1 year is equal to 12 months. Therefore, 4 years is equal to 4 into 12 is equal to 48 months. So children, you have to do these sums where you will first find out that how many days or hours, seconds are there in the higher unit, and then you will multiply. So this is all for today. Rest I will tell you in the next video.